Okay, chatty people. Let's find a seat. I have the privilege this morning of sitting next to a friend of mine. And it's a person I've spent a lot of years with. And she shared a lot of smiles and warmth with me. And I know she has with you too. Whether you've been at CCF for 2 months or 20 years, there's somebody that is a faithful servant that has greeted us, has been warm on the telephone, when you come into the church office, has spread joy and sensitivity and relationship with each one of us. And that person is to my right, and it's Lydia Whitney. Today to recognize Lydia's retirement. Her family is here, and I think they're up in the balcony, so we want to welcome all of them. And Mike and Shirley Buchanan are here. We have a little old home week, so we have some folks that are visiting with us that are putting part of our staff, and Mike and Shirley, we welcome you. Maybe there's some others here, too. Oh, Todd Hobart's here, too. Well, I don't see him. Here he is right here, Todd and Corey. Thank you. So we welcome back some of those people who have also shared a lot of memories with Lydia and with all of us. Lydia, we would love to just hear a little bit from your heart this morning. And for most of you who don't know this, Lydia has been a fixture at the church for 23 years. 23 years is a long time. Lydia, tell us a little bit about when you first came, started in your role of being on staff and what you did. What was that all about?
Well,
come on, keep talking.
He'll adjust me. Okay. It's really hard for me to remember when I first came on staff because I first started volunteering in the church office in 1993 in the fall, and just came once a month to help with the newsletter and get it in the mail and that sort of thing. And then after a period of years when I kept having things added to what I was responsible for, they decided to pay me. So that was a blessing. And then after a few years of that, the regular full-time administrative assistant left the job. And at that time, I filled in as an interim. Veronica Hall, I don't see you. Are you here today? Just like Veronica is filling in now as an interim. But after I was an interim for about 6 months, then I became full-time. And that was, Dave Whitney could tell me, sometime 2000, 2001 in that area before Brian came. And so it's been a while, and it's been a central part of my life for all of those years, and I've loved it.
What's been some of your favorite things of serving on the staff team and serving at the church?
I know who Pastor Boone really is.
And that's true.
That was a great question.
James said, keep going.
And Dave Jordan. Actually, you do get to know the staff in a wonderful, wonderful way when you're working with them day by day. And Mary Holsenbeck, who was my volunteer for years, knew that, and everyone who has worked in the office knows that you have a unique opportunity to observe them as people and not just as their staff role. And so that's been a huge blessing for me.
Lydia is one of the first people that we really met at the church when Denise and I arrived. In fact, I have a picture for us of when we first arrived, and this is a picture of Lydia and Denise. And this was, I think it was our candidacy visit. We'd come out once, and then this was the candidacy visit. We came out and got grilled every which way. And That was a picture of the ECA. Maybe you don't even recognize that, right? I mean, that was a summertime in the middle of probably August or September, and that's what the building looked like before it all got renovated. And there's Lydia and Denise together. I also have another picture, and the picture is of our staff. And this is one of the Christmas cards that we put out early on. And I always loved that one. I thought that one was extra special. And so it just kind of was a little snap back to the past there. Lydia, tell us, you have had 2 decades, more than that actually, when you consider the time that you just served in the church. Tell us, what is it you really appreciate about this body? You have perspective on that that we would love to hear. What is it you really appreciate about the church?
Well, I think one of the main things is your warmth. And time after time, I either get notes or I hear from people that are newer to CCF who say that one of the things that drew them in to keep attending CCF was the warmth of the body and how welcome they were made to feel. And that's a big part of who Jesus wants us to be, to demonstrate what his love is to those who are newer to our body. And I think you all do such a great job of that. And I love that we're consistent in our worship and in the way we serve the Lord, but we're not rigid. And that's something that really appeals to me also. And the personal way that the staff interacts with the church body, too, I think is important.
So one of the things you probably don't know about Lydia is that she's got a little tricky side to her. And I've experienced that in a very fun way. This is a story she knows that I'm going to tell because this is a favorite one of ours that we remember a lot together. There is a picture in my office, and is a picture, it's like a little photo album where you kind of get to flip between different pictures. So I kind of change the pictures, but they're all kind of around me hiking or fishing or something like that. So I have this picture right here of me, that was in Wyoming years back, and it's a favorite picture of mine, just one of the glorious days of fishing I've ever had, and kind of one of the ones that's tucked away in my mind. I went away on vacation. In fact, I think it wasn't my sabbatical, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was sabbatical, so she had a lot of time to plan. And they were, you know, I think they had a lot of ideas, and some got kiboshed.
Yes.
Lydia protected me in some ways, but
Yes.
There were some things that were going to be done in my office, and she said, we can't do that to him. But this one,
because it would not be respectful.
Yeah. Becoming of the office, right? Yeah. But this is what did happen. So I'm sitting in my office. It's been, you know, a few days. I'm just there kind of getting it all back together again after sabbatical. And I look up, and it's like, that picture's changed.
His first catfish.
Yeah. And Lydia, I looked at that and I just broke out laughing. And I said, I know exactly who did that. Because it's the lady that loves her cats. Now why she chose to put a dead cat there, I don't know. That's a big question. But I laughed about that, and actually I've left it in the photo album all these years, so I kind of thumb through it every once in a while. Just put that one back up again, just to have a little favorite memory. We've had laughter together, we've had tears together, we've had prayer together, and Lydia is one that knows me quite well. I would be able to come into the office and she'd say, can I just come back for a few minutes? She'd say, how are you? Are you okay? And she would pray with me. Those tender times of her compassion, I know were not just felt by me. They were felt by many of you who spent some time with this lady. She's going to be sorely missed. And I know many of you are saying, how can we continue as a church? Well, we will. We're slow on the throne, so that'll be good. But we would love to hear, Lydia, what some of the things are in your retirement that you are really looking forward to. What are some things that God's placed on your heart?
I won't be coming to work. That's a big thing. I don't really know for certain, you know, as many of you can have experienced this, what the Lord has planned for me. But I know he was very clear with, it's time. to move on and do something different. So I have no doubt that he has something very special for me, and my husband Dave and I are praying about that right now. And what does that mean? I'm very limited because I no longer drive. And so if Dave goes off to work, then there I am. So, but that's what I need right now. I need to be quiet for a few more weeks and to just kind of gather my thoughts and pursue what God has planned for me. I would imagine that includes some volunteer work somewhere, maybe more activity here at church, and maybe it means a few classes. But whatever he has planned, I know it'll be good because, as we all know, he is good. So I don't think that he would just bring me away from such a wonderful, fulfilling job to do nothing. So.
I know one of the things you said you were looking forward to is women's Bible study. Just talk to us a little bit about that.
Yes, I get to, you know, for a couple of years I've tried to go, but it's been hard for me to keep up with the homework and really study and absorb what God is teaching me. And it's different now because I, you know, no longer go straight to bed when I get home from work and have struggles in reading and studying in the evening. And so that'll give me the freedom to do the study, and it's a wonderful study this quarter, so I'm excited about that.
Friends, there is a reception immediately after church today. It's going to be in the ministry center, and I'm encouraging you to attend that. We're going to have a little cake reception, so for the kiddos, you get a little sweets out of it, but for the rest of us, we get something even better. It's an opportunity to hug this lady, thank this lady, and just tell her a job well done. And so I encourage you to visit us at the ministry center and specifically spend some time with Lydia. We'll also have just a few minutes that we take to hear from some of you about Lydia's role in your life and how she served this church well. I would like to lead us in prayer as we close this time, and I'm going to do something. I'm just going to stand right over Lydia and just pray a blessing upon her. Join me. Father, we lift this lady to you who has served you very well. I think of the words, well done, good and faithful servant, and I think you are handing those out to her today. And your love and compassion shines upon this lady and through this lady. So we thank you for Lydia. 23 years of service at this church, you have used her mightily, and you've shaped her as a result of this service also. So Lord, we give Lydia to you. We ask that you would continue to form Jesus in her heart, and that over these next months and years, you would convince her that your will is not, your passion and your will is not done in her life. You're still doing things. You're still going to use her for the benefit of others. And so we lay her aside now. We thank you for her. And we give her to into your hands. And we pray this in Christ's name. Amen.